Hello WordPress enthusiasts and welcome to another episode here on Themeisle WordPress tutorials and reviews. My name is Robert and in today's video I will show you how to use the latest version of the Neve WordPress theme step by step. You are free to use the theme exactly as it comes out of the box after installing it. Then create your pages and posts by using the default block editor of WordPress. But if you want more control over your content, I would recommend using Elementor, as well as other page builders out there that Neve is optimized for. The first step you should do is to install the theme, and then I will show you how to use each feature of the customizer, one by one. As you can see here, you get access to a vast collection of pre-built websites that I will show you how to import and edit with your preferred page builder. If you decide to skip a step, or you want to jump to the step you are here for, feel free to use the timestamps in the description box. Without further ado, let's get started. Assuming that you have installed and activated the theme, let's try one of our ready-to-use starter sites. I'm doing this first because there is nothing on my site right now. As you can see on the homepage, I only have the Hello World default post of WordPress, and there is nothing in my media library so far. It's a brand new website, so I would like to import some demo content before customizing the layout. My favorite page builder is Elementor, but you are free to use the layouts available for Breezy, Beaver Builder, Thrive Architect, as well as the default block editor of WordPress. I like the Creative Portfolio demo, so I will click on Import over here and keep these buttons on to import everything. Images, text, pages and posts design, blog posts, and even the contact form on the contact page. Everything you see on the preview over here will be imported and ready to use. Once I click on the Import button, the process is started. And I will enjoy my site in just a couple of seconds. Now I can go back to the site's library, which is not what I want. I can view my website, or I can click on Add Your Own Content to open the Elementor interface. I think I will do another video for showing you how to customize this portfolio template if you guys want that. It's straightforward and intuitive, so let me know in the comments if you need to know how to do it. I will be happy to make a video for you. Now that we have our demo content up and running, let's go to the customizer and change some things around. To do that, close the editor of Elementor and go to Appearance, Customize. As you can see here, I have 10 sections in the customizer. And I can start with the layout, then I can customize my header and footer area with this excellent drag and drop builder. I can change the colors of my website, as well as the typography over here. Buttons, menus, widgets, homepage settings, and additional CSS are pretty straightforward options, so let's go deep into the first settings. For now, let's discuss the layout options, where you find settings for the container, content sidebar, blog archive, and also for the single post. In the container settings, I can change the width of my website, and the great thing about it is that I can do it separately for desktop, tablets, and mobile views. The default container style is contained, but you can set it to full width as well in this dropdown. As an example, the contained setting is when you can control the gap between your content and the margins of your website on both sides. I can choose between contained or full width for all three styles separately. Let's go to the content and sidebar settings. Right here, I can choose the site-wide sidebar layout. It can be with the sidebar on the right, left, or without sidebar. I think that the sidebar is useless now when people are navigating online by using mostly smartphones, where the sidebar is pushed to the bottom of your page. The About Us and the Contact page above are made with Elementor, so the layout I choose here will not affect them. Not even the content width I can change here. If I go to a single post, you can see that the content width is affected when I change this value over here. I would enable the advanced options only if I need to control these settings separately for single posts and others. Cool, right? Let's go back and check out the blog and archive settings. I will click on the blog page in my menu to see exactly what's happening when I play with these options. Let me add a featured image to all posts so we can see how beautiful is the layout when I select the three columns grid layout in this dropdown. I think you already know how to add featured images to your blog posts, so that I will speed up the process a little bit. That's it. Now I can go back to my site and choose the three column grid layout. It looks great, right? With the masonry style enabled, we'll look even better. Moreover, I can set the excerpt length over here, the post pagination between number or infinite scroll, and so on. Moving down, I find exciting features for dragging the title and meta above the thumbnail. Hiding what I don't want to display, and settings for a thumbnail shadow like so. Cool! Also, I can change the meta order and deactivate the date of the post, for example. If I want to display my avatar, I can enable that over here. This is the gravatar image you set for the email you use in your user account. So far, so good. Now let's check out the settings of the single post layout. Again, I can change the order of the elements as well as hiding them. Let me open a single post so we can see exactly what's happening. I think it would be crazy to drag the comments element above the content, but in Neve, you can do that. On the other hand, if I hide everything, I will end up with a blank page, even if my blog post is still on the blog page. That's it with the layout settings. Let's go check out the header builder. I'm so excited about this. Just take a look at how many features I get for three different sections in my header area. I can use the header top section to display elements like search form, which I can expand the whole width of my site. Also, I can change the background color of this section and adjust the overlay opacity over here. I like that I have the row height adjustment separately for mobile and tablet users. If I toggle through these devices, I notice that there is nothing on tablets and smartphones in this section. Well, this is happening because I need to add something to the mobile version of that section. I can add the same search form as well as any other components over here. If I add the button to my desktop view and customize its content, then I add the same button to my mobile view, the content of that button will be the same. If you need components like social icons and contact details, or you want features like stick to top and show only on scroll, get the Pro add-on of Neve and enable the header booster. I can now use the show only on scroll function to display the search form and the button this way on my site. When I want to change the style and layout on one of my sections, I need to click on this tiny little settings icon on the left of that section. To customize the content of the components, I need to click on the element I want to change and use the settings in the sidebar. For example, the logo and site identity settings allow me to change the logo, site title, tagline, and turn them on or off. These elements can be displayed when you have no logo over here. I can adjust the logo width below, which is excellent. I hope I covered everything in the header area, but if you have questions or you think I missed something, please leave a comment below and I will answer each of you guys. The footer area has two sections, footer top and footer bottom. By default, I get the copyright element, which allows me to change this text in the footer area of my website. Above that, I can insert the social icons as well as widgets in footer 1, footer 2, and so on. Any widget available on your WordPress dashboard can be added over here. And then I can adjust the layout settings of my element in this tab and change each section style in the style tab. Also, I can change the way my layout works in this drop-down from full width contained to full width or contained. This is it for the footer section, so go to the colors and background settings. This is easy. I can change the link color as well as the link color on hover. You can see what's happening in the sidebar. In pages created with Elementor, these settings will not affect any color at all, so don't worry if you see no changes there. You can edit everything in the visual editor of Elementor. As the last element you can change here, this is the background image that you can set as default for pages and posts created with the block editor of WordPress. I would leave it blank, so let's go to the typography settings. In the general settings, I can change my font family, which now has a preview on the right for each font in this drop-down. So easy to pick my favorite one, right? I can use the search form as well for getting the font I want even faster. Down below the font family selector, I can transform my text like so. And then I can set the font weight, font size, line height, and letter spacing for desktop, tablet, and mobile devices, which is a great feature for making my site mobile friendly. Okay, folks, going back to the heading options, I can see that I have a font family selector for my headings. And I can change the weight, size, height, and letter spacing from H1 to H6. In the buttons menu, I can access settings like background color, text color, hover background color, and hover text color. If I change the background color, I can see that my button in the header area is different now. Cool. The best thing about this comes when I activate the block booster of Neve Pro and change my read more button style from simple text to primary or secondary button. I can also change the read more text, which is a great feature for me. When I deactivate the Neve Pro add-on, all these features are gone. By the way, you can get the Neve Pro add-on plugin by accessing the link in the description box, so make sure you check it out. Moreover, I can set top, right, bottom, and left paddings and adjust the radius of my button like so. For my secondary button, I can change both colors over here and also the paddings as well as its border radius below. Menus, widgets, homepage settings and additional CSS are settings that you already know how to use. If not, let me know in the comments and I will create a separate video for that matter, because these are default options when you customize any WordPress theme. even the default 2020 theme of WordPress. That's it, I guess. I hope that I covered every important step of how to use the Neve WordPress theme. If not, let me know in the comments what is the thing I need to come back with a video tutorial for.